welcome back. We're live for the next 90 minutes. Still plenty to come between now and 12:30. John Scott hits the shops in Paris, and we're giving you the chance to win the shopping trip of a lifetime, believe me, to the city of Love. Full details a bit later on. And from, sorry.
Do you know about that, though?
The city of Love.
Ooh.
Oh, yeah.
Have you done a bit of Love in Paris, have you?
Oh, yeah.
Oh.
Okay, so from from shopping to dropping, they're dropping like flies on Coronation
blimey,
Street,
yeah.
Thanks to dastardly Dick. Maxine bit that dust last night. Emily's not feeling so good. She has a big bump on the back of her head. The man himself, Brian Cameron, joins us live at 11:25.
And our unmissable series about babies and toddlers called Little Cherubs. It continues at 11:35, and today it's all about taking the plunge.
Jackie Stephen has all the latest soap gossip at midday. How will Ashley cope now that Richard's killed Maxine? Will Louise crack up at the inquest into Ray's death? We're getting ourselves into a right old lather at midday.
Plus, we head back to the kitchen to find out how our gadgeteers have gotten. Will the juicers be just right? Have the grills stood up to a good grilling? Find out at 20 past 12.
And, of course, we're giving you the chance to be mortgage-free in 2003. So this is an amazing prize. Just think about it. Not having to worry about your current mortgage or rent repayments for a whole year. What would you do with the money? New car, maybe? Holiday? Whole new wardrobe of clothes? Plus a new wardrobe to put them in? Maybe plus a small car as well? You are just one tiny phone call away from making your dreams come true.
Yep, and to do it, here is today's question. According to the saying, an Englishman's home is his... what? Is it A, house, B, castle, or C, maisonette? The number to call if you know the answer is 0901 499 1200. That's 0901 499 1200. If you answer the question correctly and the computer picks you, we could be paying your current mortgage or rent up to a total of £20,000 for the whole year. Details of the terms and conditions are listed on our website. That's itv.com/thismorning. Or you can find them on ITV1 teletext page 654. Lines close today at 5 past 12, and good luck.
Yeah, very best of luck. Now then, you can't have failed to have noticed that Leslie Ash's lips are looking quite a bit larger than they used to. The actress has had collagen injected into them and freely admits that they are a little bigger than she wanted.
And of course, there's Michael Jackson.
You can buy a hair that won't grow. You can fix your nose if he says so. You can buy all the makeup the man can make. But if
good gracious.
Oh dear, there's quite a lot going on there, isn't there? And to give us a guide through the pros and cons of plastic surgery is surgeon Alex Karidis, who I don't think you've got any lawsuits out against you, have you? You seem to be doing all right. When you see people's faces like that, your heart must sink that there are people around who are really damaging people's looks.
I suppose, though, you could say that, you know, beauty ultimately is in the eye of the beholder, and somebody comes in requesting very large lips, some people will say, fine, well, I'll give them to you. I suppose that in some of those pictures, obviously, they push the boundaries just that little bit too much.
Mm. Would you consider doing that? Would you give somebody that little bit extra, whether it's extra bosoms, extra lips, extra tightness? Would you do it?
I mean, as I said, you have to individualise everybody. And somebody who just wants a little bit bigger, that's fine. But if they come and say they want some extreme surgery, they may not understand the implications of what they're asking. So obviously they come to me to ask for my opinion. So I will tell them and I will explain to them that I don't really think this is right for them. That's one aspect. The other aspect is, of course, it has to appeal to my sense of pride as well, what I'm creating, what I'm making. Another, I have to look at it and say, that looks good, or it doesn't. You know, if it
another
doesn't look
couple
good,
of things also, that so it gets to the stage where you go beyond that little bit of enhancing and then it becomes obsessive. Then
yes.
You
get into a cycle.
You can't stop.
Yes.
And although it's not necessarily the fault of the cosmetic surgeon, he's the one that has to say, stop now, you have to stop. And obviously the patient's not going to listen to him, they're going to go to somebody else.
Yes, there'll always be someone who'll do it.
Absolutely.
Well, look, we've had a look through all the photos that we can find of people who have clearly had surgery. Now, this is Leslie Ash, a beautiful girl whose face is her fortune. Obviously, on the left is the before picture, the right is the after. I'm presuming she wouldn't have intended them to go that mad. I know she had it done in the summer, so 6 months already. At what stage does that start to go down?
Well, I expect in the next 3 to 6 months the lips should start to go down. Mm. I expect she's had one syringeful too many.
And is that what it would be, a syringeful?
It depends, yes. We base it on syringes, how many syringefuls of collagen or filler that you have. Mm.
So then, of course, there was Lynn Perry from Coronation Street. On the left is the before and after. She had some Botox in her lips and something else, I think, to her face. Collagen and whatever. And she did that wasn't for the better, was it?
Yes, I mean, it's not quite clear on that picture. I suspect she probably had some surgery as well around the jaw area. But it's not quite clear on that picture. But she certainly hasn't gone too extremely large.
No.
Okay.
Well, that was a few years ago, of course, before the start of all this explosion in lips. What worries me as well is that people are turning themselves into blow-up dolls. Mm. You know, the lips and the bosoms. Yeah.
They're trying to aspire to a certain image for some reason or another. You see that, and you know, you just have to tell people, look, you know, this is not going to be right for you. You know, and it's not too difficult to see, because you have some person, a lady who comes in asking for breast enlargement, and they said, look, doctor, I don't want to go too big. So you put in a very modest implant.
They come to Jordan. You. Got a big picture of Jordan here.
Jordan, yeah. As she was and as she is.
Yeah, I'm sure she's gone through a series of operations to get to that size. And so, without coming back to what I was saying, you know, they come to you and they say, after the operation, yeah, they're not that big now. Where before they were saying they didn't. They only want to go small, and then they come back to you, they say they want bigger and bigger and bigger.
Yes. It's an addiction.
Yeah. It is a
Melanie
addiction.
Griffiths, such a beautiful girl, and her husband has apparently said to her, you are not allowed to have any more, and I can understand why. There's also Jocelyn Wildenstein, the New York socialite, and Skeltskaria, as time goes
actually,
on.
She's actually deformed her face, really.
Deformed her face, yes. Yeah, Joan Rivers. Actually, Joan Rivers clearly has a very good surgeon. She's looking pretty good.
Yes, I saw her recently in an interview. She actually looked pretty good, yes. Right.
Yes, and Michael Jackson, of course, you know, scary.
We're joined now by a woman who's had extensive personal experience of going under the surgeon's knife, and it's Alicia Douvall. Welcome to the programme.
Thank you.
What do you think when you look at those pictures? Where do you put yourself in that category? Do you put yourself in a work in progress, work completed, happy with what's happened? Wish I hadn't done this.
I'm not going to have any more surgery, so. Yeah, work completed, I suppose.
What have you actually had done, Alicia?
I've had 6 breast operations.
They got bigger and bigger, and now you've had them smaller.
Yeah, I started at a AA, and I went one operation too far, so I've had them reduced.
Right. What size are you now?
Probably a double F.
Double F?
I went to a G.
You're a tiny
big.
Little waist as well.
Yeah.
And then on your face?
I had liposuction for my face. And I had a scar, so I had dermabrasion, and I've had something done to my top lip. I had collagen put in. That was like a year ago, so.
And it's still there?
Well, I don't know whether it's still there.
Well, it looks like it is. What about your nose?
No, I've not had anything done to my nose.
No.
Can I ask you why you had liposuction to your face?
Because I had a fat face. I had baby fat on my face.
You don't seem fat anywhere else.
No, well, I had baby fat on my face, so I wanted to have cheekbones, which they tell me now that it's good to have a fat face because it keeps your youth, but
how old are you, Alicia?
I'm 24.
24.
Mm-hmm.
Well, there's a programme about you tonight, actually, isn't there?
Ten to ten? No, it's at 10:50. It's called Really Bad Girls.
Bad Girls. All about you. Alex, thank you very much indeed.
Thank you both.
Thank you, Alicia. Now then, if you're thinking about having cosmetic surgery, here are Alex's tips to make sure that everything goes smoothly.
Get either a referral from your GP or a recommendation from a friend who's been treated by them. Do your research. Check that your surgeon is a member of any of the following organisations: the Royal College of Surgeons, the British Association of Aesthetic Plastic Surgeons, or the British Association of Cosmetic Surgeons. However, it's not law to be a member of one of these, but they should be registered by the General Medical Council. Once you've selected a surgeon, make sure you have one or more consultations before your surgery. Ask to see before and after pictures of similar operations. Many will put you in touch with past patients so you can be satisfied that they were happy with their treatment and the results. Most of all, make sure you feel comfortable with your surgeon. So there you go, those are Alex's tips. Of course, if you work in television, it's a lot cheaper to have the operation done. Early this morning, I went under the surgeon's knife, in fact, under the graphics knife, and that's my before and after. It's a good improvement there. And Fern had it done as well. And, look at that.
I can't think of the right word.
Kissable. Kissable.
You know those lips you get in crackers that you really... Okay, well, thank you both. Thank you very much indeed. And just be careful. Don't go mad if you're having this stuff done.
Still to come this morning, John Scott shops till he drops in Paris, plus news on how you could do the same.
And later at midday, Jackie Stephen takes her soapbox with all the latest gossip from your favourite soaps.